Maybe if I put it down this way.
Oh!
Hey guys, welcome to Filmora Pro. My name's Johnny, and today we're gonna be taking a look at how you can censor expletives or things visually on frame. This can be really useful if you don't want profanity in your video, or you wanna protect the identities of people that you caught on camera. First, we're gonna take a look at how you can bleep out audio like this. This is whew, I got quite a potty mouth there, oh my goodness. Then we're gonna be taking a look at how you can cover something up in an image, and then finally, we're gonna be taking a look at how you can pixelate or blur a part of the image and even use it with motion tracking. So if you're new here, make sure to hit that subscribe button for more Filmora Pro tutorials in the future, and make sure to hit like if you've ever sworn in your life. Okay, on to the tutorial. So I've got my footage in the timeline, and I'm going to find an instance when I want to censor out a word. Let's say right here. So obviously the first step if you're censoring speech would be to make sure that you can't hear it. I can keyframe the audio levels right here. Just like this. Perfect. Oh! However, if I want to be more dramatic about it, I could add a sine wave sound, which I can actually generate right here in Filmora Pro. Simply select the clip or the audio that you want to censor, and add the tone effect. To get this classic beep sound, try a 1000 Hz sine wave, just like this. I'm going to get rid of my audio keyframing since our beep effect will completely mask the curse word.
Oh!
But feel free to get creative and try out different sound effects. For example, I'm feeling extra spicy today, so I'm gonna add this bass boost sound that I found on the internet.
Oh!
Oh yeah, I like this one. Chances are, however, that you might want to also block out a subject's mouth as well. To do that, an easy option is to create a black plane. Drag it on top of your footage and trim it down in the editor to cover the word you're censoring. Next, using the rectangular mask tool, mask down your black plane so that it's just large enough to cover the speaker's mouth. Just like this. Finally, if you want to add a little more attitude to this effect, you could also add some growlixes. Those are the funny characters used to denote a swear word. So I'll type mine right here. And there we go.
Oh!
Next up, let's take a look at how we can pixelate or blur an area of the image that we don't want the viewer to see. I see this effect often used on license plates and faces, but you can use these effects however you want. Let's say I had a super secret project on my computer that I don't want people to see. All you need to do is add the witness protection effect and place it wherever you need to blur it out. You can decide how you want to obscure an area by going over to the method dropdown in the controls panel. I'm going to stick with pixelate. Sometimes when censoring a moving object, it can be hard to keyframe the position of what you're blocking. Luckily, Filmora Pro has motion tracking. This method is easiest on something like a graphic or one of the black bars we've been working on earlier. Right now we have our graphic placed over JJ's mouth, but we want it to follow her as the camera moves. Let's add the motion track behavior onto our graphic and set the motion from to be track 1, where our footage is. Once the footage is analyzed, we can highlight the area that we're trying to cover up. Let's also uncheck scale and rotation for this effect.
Oh gosh. So we're good? I think that was good, right? That was good? Yeah?
I wasn't rolling, so we gotta do that again.
Now, if you want to motion track with a pixelation or blur effect, like witness protection, you'll need to do a few more steps. First, take a snapshot of your first frame, which you can do by going to these dots in the bottom right of the viewer and clicking on Export Frame. Save it somewhere that you won't lose it, and re-import it into your project on a track above your footage. Next, let's mask the area that you want to censor. For me, that's this face right over here, which I'll mask with the Ellipse Mask tool. Now we can apply our witness protection effect and also place it over the person's face. Finally, like in the last example, we'll add a motion track behavior and track it to video track 1 and use tracking points on our object or our person's face. Once again, I'll turn the rotation and scale off, and here it is. Are there any fun or useful ways you'd like to use these techniques? Let us know in the comments down below. But please, keep it PG. Don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials in the future, and remember, there's no limit to what you can make.